Welcome back to what is our last Good Morning Show of the Roses weekend.
Last night, the overall scores were 154 to 108 points, which saw Lancaster storming ahead in the race to win the Cup.
That's right. Yesterday was an action-packed day with big points being won by both teams.
But Lancaster's wins later on in the day saw the margin between the two teams increase even more.
In the final fixture of the day, Lancaster won both the women's and men's darts.
Not only did they win, but they also triumphed with the women's team winning 6-3 and the men's team winning 7-2. A college select team also went head-to-head with York, winning their matches 5-2.
It's safe to say Lancaster's darts teams are pretty incredible.
It's just one of those sports which always draws in a huge crowd and creates a great atmosphere.
If you want to hear more about the darts competition, please take a look at yesterday's Roses Roundup show, which is available to view online at roseslive.co.uk. Congratulations to all the teams who brought home the points yesterday evening.
We've now got a wonderful highlights video from yesterday at Roses. In this VT, we'll see many different sports and also keep a track of how the points progressed.
So let's go see how Saturday at Roses altered the points. And it was great to see there just exactly how the points altered throughout the day with the graph.
Well, if LA1's maths is right, we're only 9.5 points away from winning the title.
Fantastic.
We will hopefully see Lancaster secure the win later on today, and we'll be announcing the winner in later on one of our shows.
If you tuned into Roses Live yesterday, you will have seen that LA1 TV had two live streams running covering games inside and outside the sports centre.
This year, we were able to bring all of the action that went on in the pool live to you.
The water sports at Lancaster have become more and more popular with the introduction of our new sports centre, and there was some fierce competition on the water.
There were all so many different sports going on in the pool. We had the swimming, the octopus, the canoe polo and the water polo. I've never even heard of half of those.
So let's take a look at the highlights from yesterday's action in the pool.
my face above the water. My feet can't touch the ground, and it feels like I can see the sands on the horizon every time you are not around. I'm slowly drifting. Touch the ground and it feels like I can see the sands on the horizon every time you are not around. I'm slowly drifting away, wave after wave, wave after wave. I'm slowly drifting, and it feels like I'm drowning, pulling against the stream, pulling against the.
Love the underwater camera.
I know, such good technology here.
It's
at LA1
TV,
having a camera attached to a pole under the pool.
That is fantastic.
Really gone all out for Roses this year.
Yeah, as well with the plane and the banner, doing
exactly.
Everything.
So last night, two of our presenters were lucky enough to be joined by the men's lacrosse team. They've had an amazing time at Roses this year. We are now handing over to Jess and Justin to hear all about it.
Hello and welcome. We are joined today by the men's lacrosse team. Here we have Johnny, Harry, Andy and Luke.
Guys, can you talk us through your match today? Because I think you won, didn't you? Was it 6-5 in the end?
6-5. It was a very hard game. York are top of their league. They've been undefeated with a goal difference of about 187. I think that's a bit specific, but I think it was around 180.
I mean, it's got to be hard to go into a match knowing that.
Yeah, but one of the things that we all spoke about before the game was we play as a team and we don't get ratty with each other and we build upon it. And up until half time, I think we were 4-0 up.
4-1
up, oh. Which, I mean, it can turn around in an instant, but I have never, in my third year now, I've never been like that at Roses, and York have always been unbelievable. So there was like that spark that we could do it, we could beat them finally, because it was 10 years since we've beat them. So it's absolutely unbelievable to be part of that.
Well, it's an excellent year to do it on the 50th anniversary, really, isn't it? Yeah. It's a big one.
Congrats, guys. Well done.
And
so can you talk us through a bit of your training? So how have you guys sort of trained and prepared for Roses?
I think a lot of it, we came back early for Roses. Andy ran a boot camp, so we were training hard for the last few weeks. Before that, it's kind of twice a week, getting down there, getting everyone involved. And it was kind of just about, we had no expectations to win. No one kind of expected us to win this game. And we kind of got our heads up in the first quarter and we realised that we could do it. And everyone, you know, the crowd got behind us. That was phenomenal. And they all flooded on at the end. It was crazy, but the training was really integral in that, so... really proud of the boys for today.
Can you go through how the match unfolded a bit, maybe?
So we started off, and as with lacrosse, I mean, if you've got any highlights, I believe you might have a few.
Yeah, we should.
So we start off with something called a face-off, and that happens after every goal or at the start of every quarter. And to be fair, Andy always wins that, so we're on the win there.
Very good face-off.
But both attack and defence, because that's the main areas of, well, many sports, but the main areas of our sport, really played well today. And
we got ahead, didn't we?
Yeah.
Mike Siddall scored the first goal. Did they equalise, or did we then score again?
We
then
scored again. I'll
take responsibility for that.
I think a lot of the way to play lacrosse is knowing how to be in attack and defence, and we showed that really well today. Like, so I play defence, and there's such things called slides. So if your man goes past you, who's covering that man? Yeah. And there was so much vocalness in that defence, so everyone knew who was their man and who should move. So we were above and beyond.
It was a ferocious game. And I mean, a lot of big hits. It was I think the crowd got really riled up. In fact, the contact today was crazy. People putting their kind of hearts on the line. So really glad to come out with a win.
Yeah, and it's so fast paced, it must be difficult. You've got to be really focused and in the zone.
It's that transition part when you're running back, it's knackered.
We're going to have to drink away the pain.
Yeah, definitely.
the running was definitely intense.
Do you plan on celebrating it big tonight then?
Definitely.
Yeah, it's going to be.
Where are you guys planning to go then?
A variety of places, but I probably won't remember where in the morning. that's the plan. So.
And can you talk a bit about the women's team?
Women's team. They're similar to us. I mean, like, York's team are phenomenal. And the girls' team played the hearts out today. And a couple of them got really emotional at the end because it was their last year. Yeah. But they're onto bigger and better things, you see, because they've had a massive influx of members this year. So things are looking up and they've got to build on that. And it's about that from there on, about how they perform the following year with their members that they've got this year. Because it's a new team and it's about building upon that.
Yeah, lacrosse has sort of become quite a popular sport now on campus. And how have you guys managed to sort of publicise the society and the sport itself and get more members?
I think we've been really lucky this year. We've had an influx of members that are really passionate about the sport and about the club in general, because kind of we've not really been known as a big kind of society on campus, but I think like this year and last year with the introduction of Andy, who's really been driving it from the captain's seat, he's really been pushing us to get known. Getting involved with English lacrosse, UK lacrosse, kind of just getting us known and getting us out there. And we've tried to push that across the board. We've got like a new website we've created, and we've really tried to make a brand out of it rather than being seen as a smaller club. We're on our way up, so I think it's one to look out for, isn't it? Yeah.
We've also got the England lacrosse team coming down for a training weekend next bank holiday May. So I'm sure Lucy will be advertising it.
But
if anyone wants to come down,
blog.
they're going to have a scrimmage, like, because I think it's the selection team for the World Championships.
Wow! Oh.
So they're doing a training weekend, staying in the hotels and stuff, and using the 3G. I think they're one of the first people to use the new 3G pitch.
I think a lot of people don't know what lacrosse is, so our job is just to try and get people knowing what, like, hearing the name lacrosse and then being interested to find out what it is. Yeah. And I think with performances like today from the women's team, even though they didn't win. And we've got mixed tomorrow, so that'll be a good game as well. Yeah. It's just about getting people down, and once they come down, as we found out today at the men's game, people were leaving, we were walking past them, and they were saying, great game, like, never seen lacrosse before, but I'm definitely going to watch it in the future, because it really got them riled up, and everyone loved watching us, so we're just happy we got people involved.
Start watching it, they seem to love it. It's quite an eye-catching game.
It is.
Going back to your whole... like undefeated York, what would you say changed within your team this year to bring a win about?
We were also undefeated until the semi-final cup against Durham, and York went on to beat Durham in that cup. They went to the final, so essentially we only lost one game. All the rest we won. We undefeated through the league, so we had a lot of confidence in ourselves.
Yeah.
But we just forgot about everything, and every time they scored, every time we scored, we just imagined it was a blank slate, and we just went on from there.
I think it was taking that kind of emotional element out of it, and knowing that, like, if you know that you made a mistake, the guy who's next to you, say, like, on the pitch, will come to you and go, right, chin up, stop it. Come on, next time we'll have him. Next time you'll be on the ground. It's all right. So it's about moving on from your mistakes rather than anything.
Yeah, it's absolutely. It's very important to just keep your head up during the game and just not let, you know, just keep going and know that you're going to win and try your best.
We had nothing to lose, so we were in a good position to come out there and kind of prove all the York players wrong. I mean, initially, the York had a lot more support than us on the sidelines, and then kind of 5 minutes into the game and people were walking past and seeing the game unfold and they were like, oh, Lancaster are winning. And the crowd just was ridiculous, and it got us going, and that pushed us through, I think, to the end, so really proud of that.
Yeah, so it's like, in a way, it's a true underdog story, because you guys sort of...
There's a generic little bit of banter from York that usually, like, the points are handed on a plate from us them, so...
They said, why are you advertising the lacrosse game this year? We're going to trash you. Yeah. And then they've lost.
So. Well, not this year, they've lost.
What a great way to end it.
And just a cheeky question. I probably shouldn't be asking this, but who is the best player out of you guys, would you say?
Today or usually?
Well,
most man of the match.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Harry played really well today.
So it's hard in lacrosse to call out a best player, because Luke plays in goal. He had a fantastic game today.
It's like in rugby saying who's the best player if you've got a forward and a back.
Yeah, that's
true. It's hard to say, but we've got a defender over here, attack, midfield and goalie. So
all of you then.
Luke played his heart out and all saved so many goals today that otherwise we wouldn't have made
it. He saved our neck.
He had a hat-trick today and Johnny put in so many good checks. So
congrats to you all.
He's the level head captain in the middle, holding us all together.
Brilliant. So what times are you going to play tomorrow?
12. The mixed game is at 12 tomorrow, so that'll be good. That's kind of a bit more... it's less contact.
Yeah, no contact.
Yeah. But yeah, it should be good all the same. Still fast paced. And we'll all be down there to support the people playing.
Well,
and hopefully we can make another win.
Yeah, exactly. Well, good luck. And thank you for speaking to us. It's been really great to have you in here.
Yeah, thank you all for joining us. And good luck tomorrow.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
We apologise there for the typo to Johnny and Harry, whose surnames are Hairsnape and Herbert, not Mersnape and Merbert. Sorry.
And as they mentioned in the video, both the men's and women's lacrosse teams will be playing today in their mixed match at 12:30 down at the lacrosse pitches.
So do make sure you go and support them if you're able to.
Thank you so much for joining our Good Morning Roses show.
We've had a really great time documenting the rises and the rises of all of the Lancaster teams.
You've had such a successful Roses, and we've got all our fingers crossed for a victory later today.
Have fun and good luck.
Bye.